Yes, you did. Okay, let's go. Shit, I have no stamina drink on me. Greetings, guys and gals and fellow gamers. My name is Games with Kicks and welcome back to 7 Days to Die. You might notice some minor differences. I'm level 63, yes. And I had some major problems. For you guys who follow me on Twitter, you already know about the problems I'm having. And for you guys who are not following me on Twitter, be sure to follow me on Twitter, because when I don't post 7 Days to Die or I have problems with my schedule, that's the place where I let people know. I won't let people know anywhere else, because it's impossible for me to let everybody know. I can't just make every single video all of a sudden for the week saying people, oh, it won't be 7 Days to Die. It's very hard. So follow me on Twitter if you want to keep up to date. What happened is basically I have a UI mod, yeah? And because I have things like this, the G4K helmet, yeah? When a patch is coming in and resets the game, it resets all the item and the XML file and the recipe XML file. So when the game tries to load, it can't load things like that, because it doesn't know what they are, so it crashes. The problem is, so basically it's my fault that the game crashed on first load, but however, to me, it is a bug as well that the game, when it crashes on first load, resets your profile. It completely resets. I had everything level 1 again. I had no skills. I had 0. Yeah. So I used basically the command give self XP to get myself back to level 57. Then I spent most of my points, as you can see here, on getting skills that I actually had trained up, that I didn't need to waste points on, to get up to a certain point, to level 20, to start at 20 again. Yeah. And I basically got everything else back to level 20 as well. My armor, my heavy armor, you know, things like that. And I gave myself all the recipes back. I think I didn't cheat, okay? I didn't give myself recipes I didn't have before. If you see anything in the recipe list, like with the iron armor, I wasn't sure. I knew I had three pieces of iron armor, and I wasn't sure which ones. I know one was the helmet, I think, because I couldn't use it, because I like to use my helmet. And then two other pieces, so I used them. But again, if you find any recipes that you think, hey, hang on a second, you definitely didn't have that, let me know in the comments, okay? Because I really did this by memory mainly, okay? So I just want to get this out of the way so that we all know why things might look different. I also started installing the orange, Clockwork Orange patch, which I think is responsible for this. That you have to update your bricks with cobblestone now first. I think that's his work. I'm not 100% sure though. That could have been something that the fun pims have changed. So you have to use cobblestone first and then you can use concrete. Okay, so that's why I have tons of cobblestone here. You know, I went basically rampaging cobblestone. I also have everything covered. Now, what I have to do before the horde comes, I'm not sure if we can record the horde in this episode. And if we can't, and I can't stay logged in, and we mess up the horde, then I'm not going to be getting really too worried about it, because I will be coming back here to fight the next, the day 70, whatever, it's day 27, 28, 35 horde instead. So I'm not too worried about it. And that way we can focus a little bit more on building the base out. So I updated the base by putting the top layer of the iron bars in here as well. And that is because you guys had a fair point that the zombies might be able to reach the bottom part. But it also gives me a double buffed layer for the spitting zombies. Okay, so yes, that's what I need to focus on. So I'm going to empty out some of my gear now, because we need to shovel a lot of dirt now. So let me keep this. And oh yeah, I went upstairs as well. I did an extra entry here, by the way, yeah? And this entry, I cleared out all the metal pieces in here and I put a little metal screen in here. I do want eventually all over here to have this, the metal, so I can shoot the zombies in the face through that, yeah? Now I don't really plan, you see, I keep leveling up. Something is always crafting, so it's you know, I'm level 63 now, which again, also, I panicked and thought, oh my god, I'm level 63. I thought the level cap was 60 and I thought I broke it because I gave myself experience through the command line up to level 57. And I posted a note on the forums, but they said, no, level cap 60 is gone and I was alpha 13. So I didn't even realize that. So it shows you what noob I am. I didn't even cop onto that. So I thought, shit, I'm gonna get to higher levels now. But that's okay. So I have some coffee up here. You see, I listen to you guys. I'm not putting any more the dirt into layers. I'm just gonna do... why does it do that? It's really annoying. It uses the plants to clip the wood against, which is really annoying. So you have to really aim funny to get the... I should have built the frames first, basically. Okay, so that's the idea, yeah, that I have just no dirt touching each other because, you know, it's pointless. And I have my crop over there. Now, I don't know, again, if that is Clockwork Orange's mod or not, but corn seed cannot be placed anymore on concrete. Now, I actually haven't read all the patch notes, but I couldn't find anything quickly looking over about anything. See, it says not possible to place here. So I think that is one of Clockwork Orange's fixes where, well, what he or she deems broken in the game, he fixes. Now, with the brick going to cobblestone and all that, I know that make logistically sense, but it doesn't really bother me too much. Like, yeah, but I'm fine with that. So I'm not going to argue about this. So I installed the mod because people told me about it and they said I should try it and I wanted to give it a shot. So feel free to leave in the comments what exactly is from the mod and what has actually changed with Alpha 13.7. But either way, we're going down now and we're going to take some wood with us because we need to craft more spikes and also, yeah, more normal spikes as well. So let's queue these babies up. And I'm gonna, like I said, I'm not gonna time-lapse this because my hope is that we are able to finish this before 10 o'clock in the evening. And that way we're gonna have the next episode then coming with the hordes and I don't lose them. Oh, hey. You want to see, you like the construction, don't you? Yeah, he came around a few times. He keeps asking me to give him a job in my construction site, but I keep telling him it's kind of a one-man show and it's, you know, it's not gonna work out. You know, I mean, I'm very picky who I work with. Let's start digging. So the idea here is that directly underneath, oh man, that directly underneath we are building for, yeah, you can see here, did I bring my bricks? Oh damn it, I left my bricks upstairs. I have to bring my bricks back because I want to basically dig a hole here and put right here my log spikes. But it also means I have to upgrade these guys to cobblestone and then to... Let's just do it. Ah, yeah. Bugger. There you go. And then upgrade to... Yeah, there you go. Nice. And let's put that here. And let's upgrade all of them. And I have plenty of... Oh, I don't actually have that much scrap iron anymore. Oh, I have no wood. I have to go upstairs and get more wood. I also have to find a better way of getting in and out of my base. And that's something that I'm gonna have to start thinking about because in the moment I have only the one entrance, which means I'm getting seriously screwed. Oh, hello. Oh, you hit me. How did you reach me? Yeah, I'm not doing as much damage anymore because, yeah, skill levels. So I better scrap all that, get extra skill points. So, because my blunt weapon damage is pretty shit now, I think. So if you look at my blunt weapon damage was at level 34, level 31 or 34 in the last episode. And I just don't have the points. I probably should spend points. Actually, I should. I should bring it up to, let me see how many points I can spend. To at least 21, because I need to be able to hit zombies in the face. And my archery was also up quite a lot, so I might want to actually get that up as well. Yeah, Okay, so that way at least I'm not like a complete idiot, because when the horde comes, I'm not gonna do any damage. Anyway, so this is my only way in and out in the moment, which I'm not really happy with. So I have to come up with a way. I was thinking about a water elevator here on the side, like take out one of those guys here on the wall or something, and put like a water elevator over it and see how that goes. I'm not so sure though. Yeah, I'm gonna have to think about that. Where's the next water source actually, because I really want to try that out. Where's the next water source? Here is a water source. That's quite far out actually. Holy balls. I might not have a choice, do I? Yeah, because I use snow in the moment for making drinking water. So, but it would be cool if you actually had a recipe to make like some a bucket of water. Can you? You can make a bucket. But theoretically you should be able to make a bucket of water out of 10 jars of water or something if you have a bucket. No, this one, I mean, that's a recipe I would see it not as a cheat. If I craft a bucket and I take 10 boiled water, it should be able to fill up a bucket. Do you not think? Let me know what you think, because that's a recipe I would love to add, because it makes sense to me. It's like, if I have the ability to have water, why does it prevent me from transferring that water into a bucket? It shouldn't. It makes sense. It's logic. Anyway. So let's go continue working down there. I need to get the wood. I keep talking too much because I'm really nervous about this whole give self XP, and I'm kind of very nervous as well what you guys think of it, because I don't want people to say like, oh, I'm cheating, because I'm not really. Like, I basically went back to the level I was at, you know, so I didn't give myself anything extra. If anything, I actually have less power now than I had before. So we're gonna dig this row, and again, I want the spikes mainly underneath. And then standard wood spikes probably, well, we'll see. Actually, this area here, I wouldn't mind completely covering in these spikes. That would actually be a good idea. And then maybe have a row of barbed wire in between. Yeah, that would work well, I think. So we could have like spikes, barbed wire left and right. That slows them down even more. And I definitely want to get another. Okay, see, we have to dig this out. Yeah, I already upgraded that, so we should be good. Nice. Sweet. Now, I don't think they will damage the dirt underneath, because they don't really hit these blocks. A crawler might actually just go left to right, but that's about it. So there you go. I think that's okay. Let's upgrade that. Yeah, I don't have a lot of scrap iron. Do I have some more scrap iron in the making? I have more scrap iron upstairs. That's right. Because when I went on my stone hunt, I got loads and loads of iron fragments. I also lost everything I had in my... not everything I had in my forges. I lost everything that I had in the slots in the forges. Like, so... anything that was already in the forges, as in burnt stone, lead, all the resources, they were still there. But I actually lost a lot of my... things that were in the forge. Again, they gave me index errors and all sorts of shit. So anything that I had in here was gone as well. So gravel, do we have more cement? Let's see. This is my cement machine over here. I always need to make cement with that all the time. Let me see. We have no fire, but we should have more fences. Actually, we need to take that with us as well instead of the hole. We can leave the hole here. We leave the bones here, that's for making glue. We actually don't need the nails. I made tons of nails because I wanted to start making chests and all that. We don't need that in the moment yet. We can leave all that. Yeah, that makes sense. Come on. And, oh yeah, I need to make magnum bullets. That's another thing I have to do. I already made loads of ammunition for the shotgun for the horde day. And now I need to just make magnum bullets, of which I need definitely this. I only have 20 bullet casings, and bullet tips I made. Where are they? Yes, here. So I need to queue up some magnum bullets. So they will take a while to do, but hopefully my gunsmithing levels up through that as well. So I can't make bullet casings in the moment because I have no caliper. And the caliper is something you have to find as far as I know, so which is a bit of a pain in the ass. So... while this is crafting, I don't think I need any more of the powder. So let's put that away. Nope. There. Let's put that away. And I made some landmines. I brought them from the other base as well. I have some pressure plate mines, which I have here. So that will all play a factor when the horde comes. Big time. Because we're gonna have them all laid out outside. So these guys are gonna be laid out. I'm going to have the magnum ammunition with me, which is good. I don't need these bullet tips in the moment. It's a pity you can't deassemble these guys into bullet casing anymore. It would be good if you could just chop them off and reuse the bullet casing. That would be nice. Anyway, 9mm rounds. Again, bullet casing I rather use for magnums because that way I can get a good shot off. Shotgun is very strong as well. Not as strong. The slug, shotgun slugs. Somebody was asking shotgun slugs. Why I don't make them instead of other bullets. The reason I do that is because the magnum bullets are for second gun. If my integrity or whatever you call it, my gun goes down to zero and I don't have time to repair it, there's no good for me having slugs for a gun I can't shoot. So I rather have a second gun with second ammunition. And I'm gonna probably take my sniper rifle with me as well and my pistol. So we'll see how it goes. So we'll see. It's gonna be a lot of gun shooting with that horde this time. So that's my dog, if you can hear him in the background, hear her in the background, that's just her going crazy. Let's get some more scrap iron. And we have some steel here as well, and that's the leftover metal bars and bricks. And we want to make cement, so... What am I missing? Oh yeah, we want to get some wood. Sorry, this is my wood chest. I'm still trying to get used to it, I only sorted that out, just literally, but... Last night I played 3 hours trying to get this all into shape for the next video. It was a lot of work, guys. So I'm sorry for not posting more frequently with 7 days to die. So let's see, wood farm or farm fence. Farm, wood farm fence. Let's make 100. 100 should, 200 actually. They should be crafting fast enough. Yeah, 3 minutes, that's fine. So, and we're just gonna start with 10 of them, put them in, start to make some cement. There you go. Oh! Just put these in there first and let's start smelting. Yeah, I smelt everything all the time. We need cement. There you go. There should be enough for the... Yeah, there you go. We have it covered. That's just to be on the safe side. Okay, so let's go back downstairs. Oh, I'm hungry and thirsty. I was wondering who's complaining. So let's take a drink. There we go. Drink done. Let's eat. There we go. And once we have potatoes, we're gonna make some, and that's why I got the corn and potatoes. We're gonna make some stew, because stew is very good. It gives you a lot of food very quickly. And I need to definitely find a way of getting down here. So what I might do is I might do 2 rows of, whatchamacallit again? Plant fiber, hay bales. Oh, I can only make 3, they need 10 each. Oh crap, we're gonna have to go on a grind as well for them. Oh, so much to do in so little time. So what I might actually do is I might actually just take the grass off before I start digging more. Now I use my hand to get athletics up just in case athletics is actually doing something more in the background I'm not aware of. I know the zombies can get into this house very quickly, but I destroyed the ladder inside that house, so they shouldn't be able to get into the attic, which means I don't have anything to worry about zombies walking across the platform behind me from one house to the other. So this video is purely just to get you really up to date with my current situation, on my levels, on my options, what happened, and what I'm gonna do to prepare for the horde. Come on, there we go. And the reason I'm not cutting anything out is because I want you to see actually how much work that is. And this is a lot of work I do usually off camera. I collect all these things individually. I go through the area and, you know, collect all the wood, chop all the trees, replant some trees as I chop them down, replant the trees again to regrow. So there's a lot of stuff that's going on in the background that takes literally hours to prepare. And that's why you don't see as much 7 Days to Die. The editing takes longer as well as in the other videos, but even without putting the music in, the editing always takes very long with the 7 Days to Die videos, because I kind of watch them very detailed again to make sure I don't have anything in that is too boring. Well, this episode might be actually, compared to a lot of other episodes, more relaxed. Come on.
There we go.
Yeah, we collect these. Why not? And there we go. Now this whole area is kind of out, and we should be able to make 12. Ah, that's a good start. So let's get some more grass, because we definitely want to get more than 12. Because what I think we should do is so that I can jump in and out of places. Oh, it's a screamer. It's okay. Hey. Are you gonna call somebody? You do, aren't you? Yes, you are. Yes, you did. Okay, let's go. Shit, I have no stamina drink on me. Which means I should probably actually lure them over my traps for the moment. And there's another screamer. Okay, I need a coffee. See, let's test this out. Look at this, guys. That's basically how the Horde Knight will go. They will just walk over these things and die. And I will just walk to and fro and start shooting some. And the... Oh, look at that. The noise they make. Holy moly. Actually, let's test these. Yeah, that's a good test. Because we want to test how sturdy the... Where's the screamer? I want to kill the screamer. There we go. We got the screamer. And did she got another horde? Yeah, I think so. Oh, that's okay. Are you guys okay? We actually have to make more arrows. I'm better gonna queue up some, that's cement. I'm gonna have to queue up some, here's loads of iron. Some iron arrows, iron arrowheads. Yeah, let's make another 250. Definitely should do that. There we go. Hey guys. Oh, look at that. They're fully upgraded spikes, by the way, so it's a good test to see actually how much damage these guys will do. And it takes them quite a long time to die as well. Nice. Okay. I don't think I need as much stamina now, seeing that they can't really run anymore. There we go. Nice. No, you see, I want people crawling. I have to hit them quite a lot now, actually, with my... No, she's grand. Because I'm only level 21, like, you know, which is obviously a huge difference to level 31. Okay, I might as well loot you guys and see what you have. Hey, soup and fat. Awesome. I have enough lead for the moment. I really want to pick up that. Let me eat. Actually, let me drop that. And let me drop that. Because I do want to pick up the... That. For when we have a caliber. Oh, hello. Shit. Well, my armor still works, which is good. Yeah, what the hell? Who's hitting me? I actually need to take a tablet. I'm infected as well. That's okay. I have antibiotics upstairs. Okay, let's see if you guys have any more. Oh, yes. Nice. I take that. Thank you very much. There's still somebody over there hitting something. Oh, hey, guys. Oh. Not bleeding, which is good. So at least we're gonna have then an army of crawlers to fight. Okay, so that was pretty exciting. Nice. Oh, I see, now I have no stamina. So I have to watch it. Okay, so let's scrap that. And let's scrap that. What do you have on you? Oh, hey! She's like drunk. Oh, actually, I like what you had there. Water. Oh. I'm not bleeding. Use it anyway. Why not? Oh, nice. That's exactly what I was looking for. Damn it. I have to be careful with them because they can actually break your leg. Nah, now I get more for this. Scrap that, drink that, and take the feathers. Okay, so that is it. That was that little screamer horde, I suppose. Let's get rid of these guys. Yeah, my hammer is not as strong anymore because my levels suck. My skill levels suck big time. Unless they fix that. Let me see. Oh yeah, they could have fixed it. Interesting. You're nodding away. Anyway. So the idea is to have all the spikes here, which I'm gonna have to upgrade now. Go level 65. The leveling keeps going really fast. I mean, while in this video alone, I leveled twice, and that is mainly through to crafting. Now again, I also don't know if part of that is because I actually did self XP, and maybe it thinks I'm on level 1 and it's giving me levels faster for less XP. I don't know. I have no idea. So let's upgrade these bad boys, and then this pretty much shows you what I... Seriously? Oh. Let's just upgrade them at least all once. Seriously? Wow. He made it all the way across. Whoa. Well, you can keep the trophy for that. I just need to know how much I have to repair my spikes now. Okay, this one isn't upgraded. And these ones are. Okay, cool. Now, I also want to get... Jeez, I'm using so much scrap iron on that I have to go on another run. Let's see how much damage we have here. Now, this is fully upgraded. Okay. Oh, this one here got downgraded once. There was a lot of zombies. Not as much as a horde, of course, yeah, but they damaged all that as well, which is interesting. So they do cause a lot of damage. It's not to be underestimated. Let's see what we have here. Yeah, okay, these ones are less so. But there was a lot of them on the other ones. So that was actually very good for testing. So when a horde comes, I know I can't rely on this alone. It's not gonna happen. There we go. But the pillars should be strong enough to withstand most of the punishment, because I also have the metal siding on top there, which is let me see, reinforced metal siding. Let me make 2, 4, 6. Yeah. I also did with the corn a test on the roof. One side is tilted with the hole and the other one isn't. So I want to see if it only needs dirt or if it needs to be holed. Ah, balls. Ugh, what a waste. What a waste. Yeah, probably have to use the steel pickaxe for that. Yeah, steel pickaxe is working nicely. The mining, once the mining is leveled up, it goes really nice and fast. So I did a couple of mining levels manually. Oh my god, are you taking the piss now? You were looking at the block and then you turn when I place you. You're such an ass. What an asshat. Now stop being weird, okay? There you go. Brilliant. And what I definitely want to do is I want to have another one of those blocks here. Let me just see. One. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 6. So here's gonna be the other one. So let's put the concrete brick down here. Right here. There we go. Gonna put it one deep. And put another one up there. And another one. And then we have a lot of platforms. So the idea is to have a huge platform here. We might need to put another one in between, I think. Let me just calculate that. So we have one. Well, right beside it. 1, 2. Okay, let me just take it from here. Oh, I might have done that actually one too far over. Damn it. Well, it's gonna be a square block as well, I think. Maybe, we'll see. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and then here would be the block. And then it would be 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Yeah, actually, that is exactly right. So we have another one here. So let's dig that out. Let's put this guy here. And let's upgrade him. You see, this is using cobblestone now. And I'm okay with that. I don't understand why it needs to be cobblestone to concrete. I personally don't get the difference between cobblestone and brick. I do get the difference as in it's stronger, but I don't get the difference as in it's just a different way of putting stones together. I don't know how you turn brick into cobblestone, really. That kind of is at a loss for me as well. So, and then we're gonna build this up high as well. So that we can put, hopefully, the platforms all interconnected. And hopefully they will be stable. That's the idea, to keep them stable. We might need to make a square of 4, though, as well. I'm not 100% sure, but we'll see. So, while I'm going to do that, I'm going to do that in the next episode, because it's getting very late now. I'm going to go upstairs and take an antibiotic, and... so I don't constantly run out of stamina. I think that's what happens when you have an antibiotic. Is it? Let me see. Infection. 2.8. It doesn't really tell you what it does. It just says you're infected. Okay, fair enough. Let's take an antibiotic. We have plenty here, I think. Yeah, 5. That's okay. Let's take a tablet. Get some health back as well. There we go. And we probably should make some first aid kits with the blood bag and take that. Alright, anyway, so this is the plan. That's what we're gonna do for the horde. I hope you're okay with that, what I did with the leveling. If you would like me to see, if you would like to see me to restart the game instead on a different map, maybe you have a map that you want me to try. Yeah, I have no issue doing that. I really don't, because to me the game is fun either way, if I start from scratch or not. Everything is fun to me. So if I build, if I run, if I gather resources, you know, it's just a question of what is fun for you guys to watch. There's always a huge difference. Anyway, so I'm gonna leave it here. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the episode anyway. And if you did, remember to kick that like button in the arse like a G4K ninja. And I hope to see you guys in another episode. Until then, as always, viel Spaß and happy gaming.